Hey, welcome back, everyone. This is Ron Hurst of Developing Leaders. Now, we're going to do take two of what I call Land of the Knuckleheads. What is Land of the Knuckleheads? If you didn't see the first video, what you'll find is that throughout my career, I've been dealing with people that are managers that don't necessarily have the leadership capacity that they need to be both a leader and a manager. So I've experienced these people as very skilled managers, but they don't have a piece of the puzzle. And in business, we often need to have both. So I want to try and highlight some of the things that managers do that really, in my world, make me think of them as knuckleheads. And I want to give you some thoughts on how to deal with it. Okay? So today in our show, we're going to talk about the open door policy. Now, your organization undoubtedly has an open door policy. And if, in case you didn't notice, most doors actually have hinges and they do open. And I think, honestly, for most managers, that's exactly what they mean. I've got an open door. In fact, I keep it open more often than not. As long as the door is open, you're welcome to come through it, Mr. Employee. Now, have you ever noticed that sometimes when you go through that door, the manager will bite your head off, or he'll bark at you, or give you a snide remark, or say, I'm busy, get out of here. You know, there's so many different reactions that you can get when you actually try and use the open door. So the purpose behind an open door policy is very simple. It's to facilitate communication and relationship building across the organization in the vertical plane, right? You're supposed to be able to go to your boss and bring up to them problems or frustrations or things that you want some help with. But the reality is that they've got so much underway and they're so focused on the efficiency of their process that often the door's really not open. You know, it looks like an open hole in the wall and the hinges in the door are off over to the side and it looks like you can walk right through. But the reality is it's actually closed. And I want you to recognize that that is exactly the case for some managers. So what can we do about it? If you've got that kind of manager who says there's an open door policy, but really there isn't one, I want you to think about a couple of things. Number one, you got to find your openings. And that means if they're coming to you, it's a perfect time to have a conversation with them. Don't just walk through the door and expect them to be able to change gears and be there for you. So find your openings. Really wait for them to come to you is one approach to this. Another approach is something that most managers will buy into, and I think they'll all readily agree. Don't bring me problems, bring me potential solutions. So what does that really mean? As an employee, I highly recommend don't go to your manager just to complain, you know, moan and whine. I mean, you know, they just don't like that stuff. What they need are employees that can get the job done. I'm reminded of a really cool quote by Henry Ford, who said, if both of us agree, one of us isn't necessary. Now, if Henry Ford were to say that to you, who do you think won't be working there the next day? It sure as heck isn't Henry. Right? So here's the thing. Managers don't need people that complain, moan, and whine. What they need are people that drive to the root cause of a problem and then bring potential solutions that will help the operation or the process perform effectively. So I really want you to think about that. Be the problem solver. Bring solutions, not problems. You know, it's one thing to go into a manager's office with a problem, but it really can be effective if you bring in potential solutions. And here's a way to do it. Don't walk in and go, you know what, that employee is treating me poorly. Don't do that. You'll just irritate them, okay? Instead, go in and say, hey, you know, I've noticed that employee X and myself are struggling to be effective in working together, and I've got some potential solutions. I wanted to run them by you and see what you think. I guarantee you, you're going to get a much better response from option B than you'll ever get from option A. So just a couple things of dealing with the knuckleheads that pretend to have an open door, but it really isn't open. So we'll leave it at that. I want to wish you a great day and lead well.